Hello students, let us continue our discussion in module 3, it is random number generation. So basic parts we have discussed earlier in our previous video which I have shared in the WhatsApp group. Let us continue our discussion. The next topic, that is test for random number. Fine. So testing, so there are various processes, different types of test we have to discuss over here. Let us see the basic things and definition. Okay, hope it is visible now. The desirable properties of random numbers: uniformity and independence. To ensure that these desirable properties are achieved, a number of tests can be performed. Okay, the tests can be placed in two categories according to the properties of interest. The first entry in the list below concerns testing for uniformity, and second one through fifth entries concern testing for independence. Okay, there are five different types of test we have, five different types. The first four categories are belongs to normally the first group, that is we are testing for right uniformity, and the last one, the fifth one, that which belongs to the second group, test for the independence. Let us see the five different types of tests in brief, one by one. The first one is the frequency test, or it is also called as chi-square test. Just concentrate over here, which I am highlighting. Okay. Here, it uthe Kolmogorov-Smirnov. Okay, name of the person, or the chi-square test to compare the distribution of the set of numbers generated to uniform distribution. Please remember, this belongs to the category number 1. Okay, this belongs to the category number 1, that is testing for uniformity. This is also called as a chi-square test. Second type, we will be discussing about them in detail. All the five different types or categories we will be discussing. The second type is runs test. Okay, this tests the runs up and down, or the runs above and below the mean, by comparing the actual values to the expected value. Actual value and expected values will be compared over here. Once again, belongs to the first category, uniformity test. Okay, then third one, autocorrection test. Concentrate here, autocorrection test. Yeah, this is what our autocorrection test is. This tests the autocorrection or correlation between the numbers and compares the sample correlations to the expected correlation, kind of a category number 2 only, runs test. Okay, again comparison, it tests the correlation between the numbers and compares the sample correlation to the expected one. Okay, correlations of 0. Comparison test once again for the numbers generated. Then we have gap test, fourth category. It counts the number of digits that appear between the repetitions of particular digit, and then uses the first one. Okay, Kolmogorov-Smirnov test or chi-square test, compare with the expected size of gap. Once again, it is the uniformity test only, because the first category of test is used over here as well. It is used to compare the number of repetition of the digit. And the fifth category is the poker test. Okay, here it treats the number grouped together as a poker hand, then the hands obtained are compared with what is expected using the chi-square test. Okay, this is testing for uniformity. Poker hand, in the sense, normally the term is used in playing cards. You must have heard about that. Okay, the cards with the similar symbols, right? The card with the similar symbol or same symbols will be grouped together as a poker hand. So this is something similar to that particular concept. So which treats the numbers grouped together as a poker hand. Then the hands obtained are compared to what is expected using the first test, that is chi-square test or uniformity test. Okay, fine. So go through the next statement. These are the five categories. No need to worry. You just remember about this, and you will be discussing all the five different categories in detail. First four belongs to the as we said, two types of or two categories of testing. First four belongs, they are used for testing the uniformity, and the fifth one is used for testing the independence. Fine, please understand that. So, in testing the uniformity, the hypothesis used for uniformity testing are as follows, okay. Null hypothesis and the other hypothesis, say H1, H0 and H1. So, let Ri be a random number, uniformly distributed random number, u between the interval 0 and 1. Please concentrate here, which I am pointing. Let me highlight this statements. Yeah. The hypothesis for testing, right? Random, let Ri be the random number. Yeah, here I have highlighted it, that is H0, where random number or the hypothesis, null hypothesis is given as for the given random number Ri, it is uniformly distributed between 0 and 1. And the other hypothesis H1, the same thing is considered, uniform distribution between the interval 0 and 1, fine. The null hypothesis H0 reads the numbers are distributed uniformly on an interval 0 and 1. You can see the definition here, what I just explained. So, failure to reject the null hypothesis means that no longer evidence of non-uniformity, okay, in the test. Failure to reject the null hypothesis, that means you have to accept the null hypothesis. Null hypothesis acceptance means it is uniformly distributed, okay. Failure to reject means that only acceptance. So, acceptance of the null hypothesis means that no evidence of non-uniformity. So, that means it is uniformly distributed, fine. So, if H0, that is null hypothesis, is true, means that doesn't mean that the next hypothesis X1 which should also be true. It can be anything, right? In the next two interval. So, 0 to 1 we have considered, let it be 1 to 2 or whatever the interval is. So, it is not compulsory that for the first hypothesis, that is null hypothesis is true, means the remaining hypothesis also should remain true. That is not the necessary condition. So, we have to go for testing H1, right. So, H0 should be tested independently, H1 should be tested independently, okay. That's what you can see over here. So, probability of a test. So, next one, for each test, a level of significance A must be stated. The level A is a probability. A stands for the probability, right? There are two possibilities. Either test can be, result can be true or it can be false, isn't it? Uniformly distributed, yes, it is true, it may be true, or another option is the false. Fine. Let A is the probability. Okay. So, A can be defined as follows. P, it is a probability of two different conditions. Either you have to reject H0 or you have to accept the H0, which you can see over here. I will highlight this if you want better, right. Hope you are understanding the concept. Let A be the probability. How you are mentioning the probability? See, there are two possibilities or probabilities. Either it can be, either you have to accept the hypothesis or you have to reject the hypothesis, right? Reject H0 when you are rejecting, if it is false. Otherwise, H0 will be true, it will be accepted, fine. So, in the next session, let us discuss in detail about the different types of tests what we have listed. Thank you for watching. If you have any doubt, you ask.